Doesn't look like anyone's here. The door's open, but you guys hang back. Hello?
What do you want?
We're just walking through this area. Just saw the cabin.
What are you,
to say
what are you
hello.
Doing out here?
Guys, turn the cameras off. Turn them off.
I know it sounds ridiculous. We're making a TV show.
You sure that's what you're here for?
Yes, sir.
Well, go ahead and make yourself in.
All right, thank you. Jessica, come.
Sketchy.
I'm Forrest.
I'm Sot Tuttersold.
Sot?
Yep.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Thanks for not shooting me.
Well, thanks for not calling the cops when I did.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah, no cops here. I promise. This is my wife,
Hi.
Jessica.
Hello. I'm not really sure about having the cameras in here. You know, with all the spills and stuff and everything, I don't know how I feel about
you're
that.
You're making moonshine.
Yeah.
I gotcha.
Yeah, that's a kind of a family business from way back. And,
uh-huh.
And we don't like people catching us.
Okay.
As long as you don't give away my position, I'm good.
Secret safe with us.
Secret safe with us.
Heck, let's talk. You might as well sample a little bit of the product here. This is cranapple.
Cranberry apple moonshine.
Correct.
Ooh, smells strong. You make this right here?
Yes, sir. It'll sneak up on you.
Yeah.
Wow, yeah, that's like candy.
This is just regular apple pie.
Ooh, this one smells stronger.
Just the cinnamon, I think. Try this one here. This is here's lemonade.
Lemonade. Yeah. I'm sorry. I wasn't expecting that. Yeah. Here, guys, try this. Taste this. It's delicious. Just try it. You'll be fine. Yeah, we've been...
He's working.
He's fine.
He's on the clock.
He's fine. Just try it. It's delicious. Yeah, so like 5 days we've been living in a tent down by the river. It's his first time, I'm sorry. He's not familiar with how bottles work.
I remember my first
time. Are you ever out here and you hear things you can't explain or that kind
of
give
you
the creeps?
Yeah, there's stuff that makes noises that just, you know, large noises that I don't know what they are.
You know, this is a TV show, but I'm a biologist.
Okay.
And what I'm trying to investigate, Jess and I, is to try and figure out if there's any sort of truth behind this Ozark Howler thing.
Oh, there's truth behind it. There really is an Ozark Howler, but we used to kind of build on it a little bit to keep people away.
What do you mean?
Well, when people come poking around, it wasn't supposed to be here. You could go out in the woods, make the noise, squall a little bit and howl, and they'd go back to town and tell everybody else, and then nobody'd come out.
No kidding. So you'd hide in the woods and make noise to scare people away.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
No.
A lot of the old shiners used to do that. My grandpa, he used to go out there and he'd squall and howl because he just enjoyed scaring people off.
So he would just howl with his voice? Or use
he had growlers he made. I got a couple of the old ones here, yeah.
No way.
Oh, this is great.
This is a growler.
Oh, wow. You guys getting this? That's amazing. That's literally making the hair on my arms stand up. It's just a bucket and a piece of string.
Yeah. He also used to howl along with that. He'd start out like a cat squall and end up with a wolf howl.
Can you do it?
Not as good as he did. But
oh, come on, give it a whirl. That's fantastic. Do you have your phone on you?
I do.
Can we record that? I want to play that for Andy and see if that's what he heard. But you said you haven't done it lately.
No, not lately.
Okay. Here
we
go.
You said it's real.
Right. I know because my granddaddy shot one.
No, he didn't.
Yeah, he did.
What do you mean?
I've got the fur.
You've got the fur?
Correct.
Here?
The actual pelt?
Right here.
No way.
And the skull.
May I please see it?
Yes, go ahead.
It's a canine.
It's definitely a canine.
Yeah. That's the pelt from a howler?
That's it.
You're kidding me.
That's what my grandpa, that's the one he took off of it.
He killed a howler, this is it?
Yep.
Wow, how old is this, Sot?
Oh gosh. That was in the mid-20s, so that'd have to be...
Only 100 years old.
He's kept it rolled up in a trunk for all this time.
This is...
Yeah,
we've been going dead end after dead end here, and you're showing me something, and I know what I'm looking at here. My opinion, and I think Jessica's too, is that this isn't a howler, so to speak, but it is a creature.
It does howl.
I believe this could be from an extinct species from the area, a North American red wolf.
American red wolves once ran wild across the southeastern U.S. and as far west as Texas. They look almost like a gray wolf crossed with a coyote, but with a distinctive reddish coat. Unfortunately, aggressive hunting and habitat destruction over the past 100 years have virtually eliminated them in the wild.
You've obviously had this pelt for a long time, but would you mind if we took just a little tiny bit of it and get some
just
DNA?
Just a sample to test it.
I'm just gonna tweeze a little bit and I'm just gonna cut a tiny bit off as well.
Jessica's a fantastic zoologist, so we'll really be able to take a close look at this and understand what we're looking at here.
There we go.
Well, cheers to you, Sud. Thank you very much for having us. This is hilarious. Guys, get some manners here, for God's sakes. Yeah. Come on now. You get the strong ones. Cheers, guys.
Running
cheers,
into Sot was an incredible stroke of luck and more than worthy of celebration. We've arranged to meet some red wolves up close here at the Endangered Wolf Center.
This is one of our American red wolf habitats.
Oh, they're so pretty.
Wow.
You guys now are looking at the most endangered wolf in the entire world.
This is the first facility in the world to successfully breed red wolves.
It's like emotion-provoking to stand here and see these animals.
Totally.
As beautiful as your enclosures are, that shouldn't be in them. They should be running around Missouri. You know, we went through this beautiful country, this habitat that looks so pristine and wild, but it's missing something so important, that apex predator. It's just terrible on the ecosystem.
Yep, and that's why we're working so hard to bring back this national treasure.
Jess and I are lucky enough to be out here at feeding time, and we're taking cover in a blind.
There's this really common misconception that if you have wolves, then there's gonna be no more deer, but it's actually the opposite because wolves are so good at managing the population that deer that are suffering from, for example, wasting disease.
When we found that deer carcass, it was gross, it was gangrenous. There was no cleanup crew. Look at these guys. You could see the critically important service that they perform to the wild world. They are out there getting rid of the sick and the weak and keep everything in balance.
Thanks for coming to meet us, man.
Good morning, Forrest. Yeah. Good to see
you
again. Glad you survived.
Now that we've seen the red wolves for ourselves, I invited Andy to join us. Jess and I want to see how he responds when he gets a whiff of the red wolf's distinctive musk.
Yeah, that's the smell.
That smells the same?
That's the same.
No kidding.
Real musty, but not dead. Almost skunk-like.
You're getting that heavy, thick.
It's heavy.
It's that canine smell. That's amazing. It's so exciting, man. How cool is that? So what I want to try to do is I'm going to play a locator howl from a different wolf recording and see if we can get them to talk back.
This is our chance to hear what Jess and I believe is likely the legendary call of the Ozark Howler.
Nothing.
No response. I want to try something different. I'm going to play the recording Jess made of the moonshiner doing the Ozark howl.
Sounds
the
That's
same.
That sound.
That is.
This is it, right here. This is it.
And you potentially had an encounter with a wild one.
Yes.
You might be the luckiest guy in North America.
I'd like to think so.
That is amazing.
It's something I never had experience with, and now I can say I do. I know what it was.
Well, I'm so glad we could put a button on this, man. I mean,
Thanks.
That is absolutely amazing.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you so much for
Thanks for having
everything,
me up here.
Andy.
This fixes it.
Just one more test to run. And Regina's offered her lab for Jess and I to test the hair and tissue samples from Sot. Now we can confirm if the fur of the Ozark howler that his grandfather shot in the 1920s matches up with an American red wolf.
Canine hairs have almost like a living center to them, a medulla.
So
it's pretty easy to tell right off the bat, these are both canine hairs.
The hairs are a match, just as we suspected.
The sounds align with the howls. The smell, according to Andy, aligns perfectly. The hairs match very similarly. More or less, everything is aligning to say that the Ozark howler is a real creature.